A very good morning to all of you. Yesterday we started the lesson, The Happy Prince, and three pages we had done. So what we read out, like the Happy Prince, whose statue is there in the center of the town. After death, actually, his statue was put up there by the people. So the prince, why is he called as the Happy Prince? Because when he was alive, he was always happy. The reason being that in palace, sorrows don't reside. All comforts, all luxuries, everything is there. So the prince was never able to experience what unhappiness or what sorrow is. So he was called as a happy prince. After death, his statue was put up here. It was made up of all gold and it had a leaden part. Its eyes were made up of sapphire and it had a red ruby at its sword. So now this prince, the one who could never ever see sorrow in the palace, but when it was being erected at the center of the city, from there it could see the sorrows in the whole city. And those sorrows made him see what life actually is. Okay, so once a bird, a swallow, comes to take shelter under its feet, near its feet, and that bird, who was actually a migratory bird, was migrating to Egypt. That bird took shelter there because it wanted to just take rest there for the night being. In the morning, it might have flown away. But that bird felt as if some drops of water had fallen on him. And those drops of water were the tears from the eyes of that happy prince. On being asked, the happy prince explained that those were the tears which were there because of his unhappy heart. Because of his heart, which was actually bleeding to see the misery in the town. That happy prince told the bird about a mistress who lived somewhere far away from that place. And there at her house, she was stitching a gown for the princess's maid. That gown which that maid would be wearing in one of the balls. Okay. And that gown which she was stitching at the time, it was night. She was hungry. She was tired. She was sleepy. And at the top of all the problems, her own son was sick. He had fever and he was asking for oranges, but she had nothing to give him anything like that. At that kind of state, the son was not able to sleep because he was feverish, but that mistress, she fell asleep because she was too tired. And this happy prince wants the swallow to take the ruby out of its sword to give it to the poor mistress so that she could make something out of it. This fellow was not initially ready to do it because he had to go to Egypt to be with his friends and family, and he was awaited over there. And but the happy prince was able to convince him. So it is said, like, when you have the right mission to accomplish, when you've got something to do which is really very, very genuine and honest and good, then you get the means to do it. Then you get it done by hook or by crook. So the happy prince, he had good intentions. He had pious intention. And he was helpless. He could not move. But the bird got ready to help him out. And the bird went to this mistress's house and kept that ruby at the table of that mistress, right? And when it came back, it told the happy prince that it was very happy and it was not now feeling very cold. Now it was not feeling very cold because his kindness had made him feel warm from within. Manavik, be attentive, look at your book. So we are on page number 30. The first three pages we had done yesterday, and I've explained all them again in case you missed out something yesterday. Now page number 30, third last paragraph. Then he Then the swallow flew back to the happy prince and told him what he had done. "It's curious," he remarked, "but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold." So what made him feel warm?
His kindness,
his kind gesture had made him feel warmth of love, warmth of kindness. But that is because you have done a good action, said the prince. And the little swallow began to think and then fell asleep. Thinking always made him sleepy. So that is always so. So when he started thinking like what he had done, so then that very moment he fell asleep. So thinking always made him sleep. When day broke, he flew down to the river and had a bath. "Tonight I go to Egypt," said the swallow, and he was in high spirits. What do you mean by to be in high spirits? To be very happy. Okay, he was in high spirits. He was very happy at the prospect. He visited all the monuments and sat a long time on top of the church steeple. So he was very happy. He visited all the monuments and he even sat for a long time at the top of the church steeple. When the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. "Have you any commissions for Egypt?" he cried. "I'm just starting." Swallow, little swallow," said the prince. "Will you stay with me one night longer?" Swallow, little swallow, said the prince. "Far away across the city, I see a young man in a garret. He is leaning over a desk covered with papers, and in the glass by his side there is a bunch of withered violets. His hair is brown and crisp, and his lips are red as pomegranate. And he has large and dreamy eyes. He is trying to finish a play for the director of the theater, but he is too cold to write anymore. There is no fire in the grate, and hunger has made him faint." So now, when this bird came to take his permission to go to Egypt, then Happy Prince again requested him to stay for one more night with him. The reason being that night he was able to see a man who had to write a play for a theater. But it was too cold for him that he was not able to write anything. And moreover, he was hungry. There was no fire in the grate or in the hearth of that, place. And he had nothing to warm himself with, or he had nothing to feed himself with. So he had become very faint, or he had become very weak, and he was not able to write any play for the theater. "I will wait with you one night longer," said the swallow, who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. So now the bird says, should I take one more ruby to the playwright? Who is the playwright? The one who writes plays. The one who writes plays. So learn the spellings also. "Alas, I have no ruby now," said the prince. "My eyes are all I have left. They are made up of rare sapphires, which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago. So you know India earlier was a golden sparrow, right? And it is even mentioned in the stories. So that happy prince told him, now I don't have any more ruby with me. But yes, now I have got 2 sapphires and my eyes are made up of sapphires, and those sapphires were brought from India many years ago. So he ordered the sparrow to pluck out one of them and take it to the playwright. "He will sell it to the jeweler and buy firewood and finish his play," he said. "Dear prince," said the swallow, "I cannot do that." And he began to weep. Why did the bird begin to weep? So why did the bird start crying? Yes, because taking sapphire out of the eye of the prince would mean that making him get hurt. So the bird didn't want to hurt the prince. So he started crying. "Swallow, little swallow," said the prince, "do as I command you." So the swallow plucked out the prince's eye and flew away to the young man's garret. It was easy enough to get in, as there was a hole in the roof. Through this, he darted and came into the room. So through that hole, which was there at the roof of that garret, he entered the room. The young man had his head buried in his hands. So he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wings. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire lying on the withered violets. Why couldn't the young man listen to the fluttering wings of the bird? Because his head was buried in his arms or hands, you can say. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire lying on the withered violets. "I am beginning to be appreciated," he cried. "This is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play." And he looked quite happy. So what did the playwright think? He thought that the sapphire had come from his fan, that it had come from somebody who admires him. Right? So he was very happy and he was sure that he would be able to finish the play. Now, the next day, the swallow flew down to the harbor. What is harbor? Shore. Now, the next day, the swallow went towards the harbor. He sat on the mast of a large vessel and watched the sailors working. So, when he sat on the mast of a large ship and he saw the sailors working. "I am going to Egypt," cried the swallow, but nobody minded. And when the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. "Swallow, little swallow," said the prince, will you not stay with me for one more night?" "It is winter," answered the swallow, "and the snow will soon be here. In Egypt, the sun is warm on the green palm trees, and the crocodiles lie in the mud and look lazily about them." So why was the swallow so eager to go to Egypt? Okay. It was not just for the friends. It was for his life also. In this city where he was right now, he didn't know when the snow would start falling. In snowfall, this bird would not survive. So his life was at stake here. Okay, secondly, in Egypt, the things are very warm. So in order to survive, he should shift there. He should migrate there at the earliest. Okay, so it's not just for the friends. It's just not for family. It's just not for fun. It is for life also. Okay, and when winters come, you never know when the snow would start falling. So maybe this very night the snow would start falling. But even then, he will get ready to stay for one more night with the prince, right? In the square below, said the happy prince, there stands a little match girl. She has let her matches fall in the gutter and they are all spoiled. Her father will beat her if she does not bring home some money. And she's crying. She has no shoes or stockings and her little head is bare. Pluck out my other eye and give it to her and let her father not beat her. So what's there now? What story the happy prince has today? He says that there somewhere there in that square, there is a little girl. She sells matchsticks. She sells matches, matchboxes to earn a livelihood. But today she had thrown her matches in the gutter. So she has not been able to earn any money. And if she goes her home like that, then her father would beat her. So you take my other sapphire and give it to the girl, and the girl will give it to her father, and father will not beat her. Swallow the little... So he plucked out the prince's other eyes and darted down with it. He swooped past the match girl and slipped the jewel into the palm of her hand. "What a lovely bit of glass," cried the little girl, and she ran home laughing. Then the swallow came back to the prince. You are blind now, he said. So I will stay with you for always. Got it? So the bird realized that the prince had become blind. Now he decided to stay with him forever. No, little swallow, said the poor prince, you must go away to Egypt. No, I will stay with you always, said the swallow, and he slept at the prince's feet. All the next day, he sat on the princess's shoulders and told him stories of what he had seen in the strange lands. So what did the bird do with the prince? He told him the stories about the strange lands which he had visited. Dear little swallow, said the prince, you tell me of marvelous things, but more marvelous than anything is the suffering of men and women. There is no mystery so great as misery. Fly over my city, little swallow, and tell me what you see there. So the happy prince, he told him that, dear, you tell me so many beautiful stories, but the most mysterious stories are the ones which are about the misery of others. So you visit, you have a round of my city and tell me if there is anyone who is suffering. So the little swallow flew over the great city and saw the rich making merry in their beautiful houses while the beggars were sitting at the gates. He flew into dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly at the black streets. So what did that bird see? He saw the rich people having all good time in their houses, whereas the poor people suffering outside on the roads or at the gates. Then he flew into the dark lanes and saw the white faces of starving children looking out listlessly at the black streets. So then he visited the dark streets where the poor people live. So there he saw the hungry children. He saw anemic children, white faces. The people who have white faces are not that they are very fair. They are anemic, you know, pale faces. So he saw starving children there who were looking listlessly. What is listlessly? Like a dumb person. When you're hungry, when you've not got anything to eat, when there is nothing for you to keep on, then you look at something listlessly, like a dumb person. So they were looking at the things listlessly. Under the archway of the bridge, two little boys were lying in each other's arms to try and keep themselves warm. Then the bird saw two boys clinging to each other to keep themselves warm. How hungry we are, they said. You must not lie here, shouted the watchman, and they wandered out into the rain. Then he flew back and told the prince what he had seen. I am covered with fine gold, said the prince. You must take it off, leaf by leaf, and give it to the poor. The living always think that gold can make them happy. So how ironic. The happy prince, we'll discuss whether it was really a happy prince or not. So the prince, you know, told the swallow that it must take the gold off its body and give it to the poor, leaf by leaf. Because it is said, like, people, those who are alive, they say that gold can buy happiness. Okay? Leaf after leaf of the fine gold, the swallow picked off till the happy prince looked quite dull and gray. So finally, the happy prince started looking dull and gray because whole gold, all gold from its body had been shredded off. Leaf after leaf of the fine gold he brought to the poor, and the children's faces grew rosier and they laughed and played in the street. So when this fine gold was given to the poor people, they might have sold it and they might have got a lot of money, and with that money they ate, okay, and their faces became rosier and they laughed and played in the street. We have bread now, they cried. So why were they happy? Because they had got food to eat. Then the snow came, and after the snow came the frost. The streets looked as if they were made of silver. Everybody went about in furs, and the little boys wore scarlet caps and skated on the ice. So those very boys who were earlier hungry and naked and did not have anything to cover themselves with, now those boys had fur coats and scarlet caps, and they were now skating on the ice. So when you've got everything, then you got, then the same ice can be a source of amusement for you. Otherwise, the same ice can kill you, right? But at last, the poor little swallow grew colder and colder. But he would not leave the prince. He loved him too well. He picked up crumbs outside the baker's door when the baker was not looking and tried to keep himself warm by flapping his wings. So, but the bird did not have anything to survive on. So it took some crumbs from the baker's shop from outside, and then it tried to keep itself warm by flapping its wings. But at last he knew that he was going to die. He had just enough strength to fly up to the princess's shoulder once more. "Goodbye, dear prince," he murmured. "Will you let me kiss your hand?" So finally, when the bird was about to die, it gathered all its courage and sat somewhere on its shoulder. And it told the prince that it wanted to kiss his hand. "I am glad that you are going to Egypt at last, little swallow," said the prince. "You have stayed too long here, but you must kiss me on the lips, for I love you." It's not to Egypt that I'm going. I am going to the house of death. Death is the brother of sleep, is he not? And he kissed the happy prince on the lips and fell down dead at his feet. At that moment, a curious crack sounded inside the statue, as if something had broken. So what might have broken? The fact is that the leaden heart had snapped right into two. It certainly was a dreadfully hard frost. So what happened? The moment the bird died, that very minute, the happy princess's heart broke into two. So what happened? First, his statue broke into pieces, then his heart also ripped into two. It certainly was a dreadfully hard frost. So it was actually, this is what the people might have said. So it was really a hard frost which made the happy prince get ripped off. Early the next morning, the mayor was walking in the square below in company with the town councillors. So the next morning, the mayor was walking about with other town councillors. As they passed the column, he looked up at the statue. "Dear me, how shabby the happy prince looks," he said. "How shabby indeed," cried the town councillors, who always agreed with the mayor, and they went up to look at it. "The ruby has fallen out of the sword. His eyes are gone and he's golden no longer," said the mayor. "In fact, he's a little better than a beggar. And here is actually a dead bird at his feet," continued the mayor. "He must really issue a proclamation that birds are not to be allowed to die here." And the town clerk made a note of the suggestion. So this is what the system works like. Yes, this boy. Anji, what's your name? What's your good name? I must not say bad name. Are you Harshit? Start up. I had to tell him to leave the class. Now he leaves. Enjoy outside. And I'll call your parents right now. And your parents will be going inside and talk to the principal. Right? Tell your parents to be in the principal's office on behalf of your best friend. Would that be fine? Yes?
No.
Why no? Abhi to best friend tha wo. Friendship has one line, hai na? It has limits, right? I'll talk to you. You people are new to me, hai na? That's why you're talking like this. Keep standing, I'll talk to you later on. Yes. So what we were talking about in the chapter, Harshit? Stand up, you. I'll talk to you also later on. So they pulled down the statue of the happy prince, as he no longer beautiful. He is no longer useful, said the art professor at the university. So finally, the statue was pulled down because it was not beautiful. Then they melted the statue in a furnace. What a strange thing, said the overseer of the workmen at the foundry. This broken lead heart will not melt in the furnace. We must throw it away. So they threw it on a dust heap where the dead swallow was lying. So the heart did not melt in the furnace. So they threw that leaden heart at a place where the dead swallow was buried. Bring me the two most precious things in the city, said God to one of his angels, and the angel brought him the leaden heart and the dead bird. You have rightly chosen, said God, for in my garden of paradise, this little bird shall sing forever, and in my city of gold, the happy prince shall praise me. Got it? So God appreciates the ones who are kind, generous, and the ones who don't mind sacrificing their life for the poor and needy. But yes, the world is exactly the opposite. In this world, the people who are rich, the people who look good, they are given value or they are given the importance. But in the house of God, it's not so. So the point is, let's spread happiness. Let us spread love and peace all around, because that is what which is going to be valued in the end. Okay, other things are all secondary. Okay, so that's how the story has finished. So tomorrow we might discuss the question answers of this very story. Then this literature syllabus has finished for this term. Then we'll see some writing skills. Otherwise, from literature part, our syllabus has finished. Right? Questions we'll discuss tomorrow. And start sending me the notebooks in complete form. Earlier also you sent me the PDFs. Okay, you can attach your these questions with the same PDF and resend me. Okay? Right? And you can delete your previous PDF from my system also. Will you do that?
It's not possible. It is for only one.
Try it. It is only?
For 1 hour.
1 hour? For 1 hour?
Yes.
15 hours. Okay. Then you resend your PDFs complete. Okay? So till tomorrow you will be able to send? Tomorrow we'll discuss, then afterwards. Tomorrow by evening, you'll be able to send me the PDFs. Just a minute.